Good morning, Mr. Secretary.
Good morning.
I am the Lorax. I speak for the trees. I speak for the trees have no tongues. Many of us know that as Dr. Seuss, and as we approach Dr. Seuss' birthday, I always find it fitting that usually the Department of Environmental Protection is before us during that week. Many parents and teachers will be reading quotes from Dr. Seuss this week, and I find that quote fitting because often you are the Lorax for our Commonwealth and for those individuals and those communities that cannot speak, that do not sit on the boards of corporations and maybe do not even sit at the table with the environmentalist groups, but are often impacted by bad environmental policy. In fact, part of your mission is to provide for the health and safety of the citizens through a cleaner environment. And one way in which your department does that is by operating the Office of Environmental Justice. And in that office, it's my understanding that you look at areas which are defined as any census tract where 20% or more of the individuals live in poverty, or 30% or more of that population is a minority. And those areas spread across the Commonwealth include counties like Greene and Fayette, Allegheny, Jefferson, Indiana, Clearfield, Luzerne, Lackawanna, Philadelphia, and many, many more. Can you share with me the mission of that particular office and how your budget has been impacts the effectiveness of that office right now?
Certainly. First, I think in particular, leading into that, the Lorax analogy is particularly apt. The Office of Environmental Justice has the responsibility for speaking for those who have little voice in the process, typically. As you say, we currently look at the 20 and 30% to identify communities. We have made sure that we have the resources we need across the board, starting with Carl Jones, who's the director of that office, works predominantly out of our Southeast region. A couple of things we're doing are, one, it's been over 10 years since we established the initial environmental justice policy, and that was, we were one of the leaders at that point. Well, lots happened within the environmental justice community since then, so we've created an internal work group to relook at the policies, but more importantly, we're going to be creating a process by which we're going out doing some external listening sessions across the state in these communities to talk about where we are, what we can do better. Some of the things that have already been thrown in on the table are even the definition of an environmental justice community, where we look at income and we look at minorities. Maybe we should also be looking at things like prevalence of homes where English isn't the primarily spoken language, because that creates an additional educational piece for the department as we think about and go into. So there's going to be a focus and a recommitment to what we do within the environmental justice area of the department.
I look forward to working with you on that. I hope that to host one of your listening sessions.
Absolutely.
I have a second question, and then I share this question with every department, and that is in regards to your personnel and the reflection, how it reflects the Commonwealth, and if you can share with me any demographics in regards to the number of women that you have employed in your department, number of minorities, and if any of those individuals are in any position of management or supervision.
Sure. We have, I will fully admit, we don't have as good a story to tell there. We are at about half from a diversity, and we're about half of what the average Commonwealth agency is. We're over 7%. The average Commonwealth agency is around 14%. On women hiring, we're inverted from the rest of the state, where the rest of the state's about 40 male, 60 female. We're well over 60% male. Now, that said, one of the things I've asked our staff to do is the governor's put together a task force specifically to look at the diversity hiring issue, and I've told my staff I want us to be all in on that effort and whatever we can do to encourage opportunities within schools to bring a more diverse workforce into the department. That is absolutely something we're interested in.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I have no further questions.